How are you guys doing? Today is Thursday, September 2nd, 2021. I'm James Sims, and for this episode of The Elite, I'm going to use this episode to establish an elite profile for Brandon Ingram. The elite small forward for the New Orleans Pelicans turns 24 today. So my intent with this episode is to at least bring light to the accolades, achievements, and just what he's been able to accomplish from the moment he reached the big stage, even before he made it to Duke, to where he is right now, to where he was named the NBA's most improved player. And he is a player that before turning 25 has already been named an all-star, one of the best players in this league. So just to give a little bit of background into Brandon Ingram, the player that many are familiar with for his days at Duke, he actually grew up in Kinston, North Carolina. So, of course, coming up in North Carolina, the decision was tough, but he would end up choosing Duke, the right school, wink, wink. I was, Duke, yeah, you know. And following that decision, but before that, he was North Carolina's Mr. Basketball, and he was a McDonald's All-American to give a sense of how good he was. He was probably one of the top three prospects in his draft class, and in his only season with Duke, because of course he was a one and done at Duke, because of course being a one and done is synonymous with Duke basketball. He would go on to play his only season in 2015-16. He would start 34 of the 36 games in a season where the Duke Blue Devils would finish with a 25-11 record. This team would eventually get bounced in the Sweet 16 by the first seed in that division, Oregon. But within that season itself, in the 36 games he played, he averaged 17.3 points per game while averaging about 34 and a half minutes per game in a 40-minute game that averaging 5.5 minutes on the bench is pretty impressive, especially competing in the ACC with a lot of players that are older than you are, and in that, yes, at the same time as you, have D1 scholarships to their schools. So he was averaging 17 points a game on 44% shooting from the field, 41% shooting from three on 5.5 threes taken per game. So he was shooting them. He was taking a lot of them. And he shot 68% from the line. In addition to his 17.3 points, he averaged 6.8 rebounds. He averaged a couple of assists. He averaged 1.1 steals and 1.4 blocks, as well as just 2 turnovers per game at Duke while being the go-to guy. Following his one-and-done season, Brandon Ingram was taken with the second overall pick in the 2016 draft. And just looking at players who, just to give a little bit of background of players that were in that first round, Ben Simmons was the player taken before Brandon Ingram, the number one overall pick. The pick taken after him was Jaylen Brown, the shooting guard for the Boston Celtics, who was just named to his first All-Star game. The 11th overall pick was Domantas Sabonis, the power forward for the Indiana Pacers, who was just named to his second All-Star game. And the 27th pick was Pascal Siakam, the NBA's most improved player, I believe, in 2019. But regardless, that was a little bit of the background, but that was the draft that he was taken second overall in. He was taken by the Los Angeles Lakers, and that was where he played the first 3 years of his career. Starting with his rookie season in LA, in his age 19 season, he would start 40 of the 79 games he'd play in the 2016-17 season, which would be a season where the Lakers would finish with a 26-56 record. They finished with 9 more wins in the previous season, but they still finished with the second worst record in the West. This was the season following Kobe's final season, so this was year one of the rebirth. In the 79 games he played, he averaged 29 minutes a game. He averaged 9.4 points off of 40% shooting. He would shoot 29% from three and 62% from the line. He also averaged about 4 rebounds, a couple of assists, half a steal and half a block. And like I said, the Lakers would not finish that season in the playoffs. But of course, regardless, he would come right back at it. He would make the All-NBA, or he would make the All-Rookie second team. And this would propel him into a second season with the LA Lakers. In 2017-2018, he would start all 59 of the games he would play. This would be the first season in which he was the full-time starter. He would start all 59 games he would play in a season where the Lakers would finish with a 35-47 record. They would go on to win nine more games that season. In that season, Brandon Ingram would go on to, he would average 5 more minutes a game. He averaged 35.5 minutes a game. He would see his points per game double from roughly double from 9.5 points to 16 points per game, while shooting 47% from the field. So the first time he shot at least 45% from the field, he shot 39% from three, and he went on to shoot 68% from the foul line. He would go on to average 5.3 rebounds a game, 1.3 more rebounds than he did his rookie season, and he averaged 3.9 assists, which is almost double what he did his rookie year. His steals went up from 0.6 to 0.8. His blocks went up from 0.5 to 0.7. His turnovers also increased from 1.5 to 2.5. But regardless, from his first season to his second season, Brandon Ingram made the necessary jump to prove that at least he was a fighting force on this team. The very next season would be 2018-2019. That would be known as the season in which LeBron James would join the Los Angeles Lakers. He joined the team that offseason. That was Brandon Ingram's last season on the team. 2018-19, he would start all 52 of the games that he would play in a season where the LA Lakers would finish with a 37-45 record. They were on pace to make the playoffs, but when LeBron James got hurt, they would go on to spiral and completely fall out. In this season itself, Brandon Ingram would average about the same amount of minutes. He averaged 33.8 minutes. He would see his points per games go up from 16 to 18, while he was shooting 49% from the field, 49.7, the highest percentage he shot from in a season thus far in his career. He shot 33% from three, and he would go on to shoot 67.5% from the foul line. He'd see his rebounds per game stay at about 5.1. He saw his assists dip down from 3.9 to 3. He saw his steals dip down from 0.8 to 0.5, and he saw his blocks dip down from 0.7 to 0.6, so they were roughly about the same. And then, like I said, the Lakers are go on to miss the playoffs completely. Following his three seasons in LA prior to his age 22 season, Brandon Ingram would be officially traded alongside Lonzo Ball, Josh Hart, and then the rights that would go to DeAndre Hunter for Anthony Davis in the Anthony Davis trade. So Brandon Ingram was directly in this trade. And once he would end up on the New Orleans Pelicans, he would first play there in Zion's rookie season. That would be his very first season there too. So the New Orleans Pelicans would start their dynamic Duke duo at the same time. In 2019-20, this would be a season that, of course, was impacted by COVID to the point where after the All-Star game, they had to delay the end of the season because, of course, everyone had to go into quarantine. The teams that qualified for the playoffs went into the bubble, and then they would play it out and this season. But in the 2019-20 season itself, it was the only season to date in which Brandon Ingram has been named an all-star in the NBA for the New Orleans Pelicans. He would see himself start all 62 of the games that season, averaging just about 34 minutes a game, what he was doing before, for a New Orleans Pelicans team that would finish 30-42 with the 13th best record. That season, Brandon Ingram would also go on to win the most improved player. He would see his points per game shoot up from 18.3 to 23.8, a 5.5 point increase. He shot 46% from the field, wasn't as high as the year before, but he was shooting at a higher volume. He shot 39% from three, which was significantly higher than what he did before. With 39.1, that is the highest three-point percentage he's ever shot in his career to date. He would go on to shoot 85.1% from the foul line, which is a big jump up from what he was doing the years before. He shot 17% better from the free throw line. His rebounds per game went up from 5 to 6 rebounds a game. His assists went up from 3 to 4 assists a game. His steals went up from 0.5 steal to 1 steal a game. His blocks stayed at about 0.6 as well. And even though the Pelicans wouldn't make the playoffs, Brandon Ingram winning the most improved player would garner some respect from a lot of players around the league. Because many people expected him to be this good. I think the fact that he wasn't as physical as the other players might have stunted his growth a bit. But at the same time, he was able to catch up and find his own way in the NBA and use his length his own way. But following that season, this would lead us to this most recent NBA season in 2020-21, his age 23 season. In his age 23 season, he would start all 61 of the games that he would play for a Pelicans team that would finish 31-41. They played the same amount of games, roughly, and they would win one more game than they had won the previous season. Brandon Ingram would, in the 61 games that he would play, he'd start about 34.3 minutes a game, the most minutes he's averaged to date. He would average 23.8 points per game, just identical to what he did last year, shooting 46% from the field, virtually identical to what he did last year. He shot 38% from three, virtually identical to what he did last year. And he shot 87.8% from free throw line, which is 2.5% better. He would go on to average 4.9 rebounds, which is at least one rebound less than what he did the year before. But he also averaged 4.9 assists, which would be the most assists he's ever averaged in a season to date. He averaged 0.7 steals and 0.6 assists. And even though the Pelicans would not make the playoffs, of course, this would lead us to where we are right now, where Brandon Ingram is entering his age 24 season. The season is right around the corner, starts in about a month. He will get a chance to play with Zion Williamson, who's just playing right alongside him. They're growing and gelling incredibly well, especially working off of each other's games. And I can't wait to see what this New Orleans Pelicans team has in store. I want to thank everyone once again for listening to all 11 minutes of this piece. I want to thank the college basketball and pro basketball reference websites for giving me the facts and figures that I needed in order to complete this. And of course, I want to thank everyone once again. I hope all is well. If you ever get I want to wish Brandon Ingram a happy 24th birthday. If you ever get a chance to watch him, he is wearing number 14 for the New Orleans Pelicans as of now. With Hurricane Ida having just hit, I have no idea if the New Orleans Pelicans, how many of their games are going to be delayed at the start of the season, if any. Because a lot of New Orleans is without power at the moment, but hopefully Brandon Ingram and Zion Williamson alongside the city of New Orleans and the citizens itself and can help rise New Orleans and the state of Louisiana from this. But that's just the impact that Brandon Ingram has. And once again, today is Thursday, September 2nd, 2021. Happy 24th birthday, Brandon Ingram. I'm James Sims, and this is The Elite. Thank you for listening to my piece, and peace out. I'll catch you with another episode tomorrow.